Good morning, students. Today we will move ahead with the topic digestion of food. Digestion of food in small intestine starts from the duodenum. Duodenum is the first part of small intestine. It receives food from the stomach. It receives food that is partially digested, means half digested. The food is not digested completely yet. And at the same time, it also receives some of the juices, digestive juices from the pancreas, which is one of the gland, and bile juice from the liver, that is the another gland. It means duodenum is a site in the small intestine which receives pancreatic juices from pancreas, bile juices from the liver, and partially digested food from the stomach. Now, we know what happens in earlier slides and video. I have already taught you that what happens in duodenum, how the food is digested by the action of pancreatic juice and bile juice. This we have done. Now, see what happens ahead of the duodenum. Now, remaining parts are jejunum and ileum. Digestion and absorption of food gets completed here in small intestine. In which part? Basically, the lower part, that is jejunum and ileum. See how the food gets completely digested by the action of one of the enzyme called Seucus entericus. This enzyme is very important and it is secreted by the inner wall of the small intestine. As the inner wall of the stomach acts as a gland and it secretes gastric juices, same way the inner wall of the small intestine, basically of jejunum and ileum, secretes Seucus entericus. It's a kind of enzyme which finally digests carbohydrate into sugar, fat into fatty acid and glycerol, and protein is broken down into simple form, that is amino acid. So we can say the digestion of food gets completed in small intestine. The complex food now is broken down into its simple form by finally Seucus entericus, which is secreted by the inner wall of the small intestine. Okay, so digestion of food gets completed. Sometimes 1 mark question comes, name the site of complete digestion of food in human digestive system. So answer will be small intestine. Now, as I told you, digestion of food gets completed in small intestine. At the same time, absorption of the food also gets completed in small intestine. Now we know the food is in its simple form. Earlier, it was in its complex form, but now it is in its simple form. Now this simple food has to be given to the blood. But how it will go to the blood? That also happens in small intestine. That's why we say small intestine is the site of digestion of food as well as the absorption of food. Means the blood absorbs the food in its simple form. But how the blood absorbs the food? Now, absorption of food. Actually, what happens is the small intestine, its inner wall, you can say from inside, I have drawn some finger-like projections. You can see these finger-like projections. So, inner wall of small intestine has finger-like projections called villi. They have got large surface area. Because of these finger-like projections, now you can see the surface area of the small intestine increases. I have given you the view here where I have shown the small one of the portion of small intestine, and you can see the inner wall of the small intestine is folded. It has finger like projection. These blue colored structure, you can see these are the villi, and villi increase the surface area. At the same time, what happens, the small intestine is richly supplied by or covered by the blood capillaries. These red structures are the blood capillaries. Okay, so this blood capillary surrounds the small intestine, and from inside the small intestine is folded into villi. Now what happens, this blood absorbs the food because the food is now in its simple form. So it just absorbs the food in its simple form. And how it goes from the small intestine to the blood, you will say that ma'am, both are having the membrane. So the how the food goes, it goes by diffusion. So the food in its simple form gets diffused into the blood. This is how it happens. So that's why we say that small intestines are the site of absorption of the food as well as digestion of the food gets completed. Because of this special design of small intestine, final absorption of food becomes easier and faster. Easier because of its large surface area and rich supply of blood capillary. And why faster absorption of food is required? So that the food in its simple form may be absorbed by the blood and it will reach to the destination, that is cell. It's just